So here's a few seconds of the vase I'm going to work on today.
Okay, I've started with my, I think it's red Apelle, or I'm not sure exactly, but it's got the little bumps all over it. It has a wax on it, so I've dunked it in hot water. It's going to eventually boil, which I think it's just about to. The wax will float up. I'll let it cool. Interestingly enough, the wood is denser than water, so it's sinking, which is good for me. If it was floating, I'd have to put something on top of it and all that other stuff. So in any case, it's looks like it's making some progress. Okay, I'm getting ready to make an epoxy cast vase. And what I've got here is I'm going to have a, I think it's red or bull mallee. I'm not sure what it's called, but I think that's what was written on the side of it. My intent is to have a mostly transparent blue casting in here. I've put this all together with hot melt glue. We'll see how it, I'm going to have to obviously use a saw to get the wood back off. Because it's going to be all resined up. But in any case, I've got I had to boil these to get the wax off. And additionally, I microwaved it to get some of the water back out of it. And that, I think, drove off the last of the wax. There was a bit of wax on this thing when I first got it. So that's how I got it where it is. It's hot melt glued, staked in, and then the box was made independent with, so it's not, the only place these are glued to the box is at the corners. Obviously, once I fill it with epoxy, it's going to be glued to the box all over the place. So we'll see how that goes. Okay, here is my next casting along with some usage of the extra epoxy. So I got the bull Apelle. I'm not sure what it is exactly, but I've slightly tinted the epoxy blue, hopefully not too dark. And you can see the wood in there, here and here. Then I've got some chair back pieces that are in a cylinder that I'm going to epoxy. It's just my catch-all epoxy. Okay, the basic shape is done. My intent here is to have the shape not take away from the wood itself. So I'm making a very simple shape. I got to fool with a little bit to get some of the bumps out of it. But overall, it's just going to be straight with a little taper in the top. And so I think this will work out really nice. I still got to do some work on top before I'm done. So I'll have to be unsupported on this end and have the, maybe I'll put the wheels on here to make it so that it's supported. So when I'm shaping this end here, I don't screw it up. Okay, I've completed my vase that I started out with, these bull malay and blue tinted, lightly blue tinted epoxy. I had a square that I bought at a place that I was able to cut in half and turn around and face each other. And that's my result here. I wanted to call this blue sea cave or sea cave or something along those lines. I haven't figured it out yet, but in any case, it turned out really nice. I like the color contrast and its size. It's about 12 inches tall. My intent is to put, it's got a glass test tube in it to allow you to put live cut flowers. And that's about it.